Balik po tayo dito sa Kababayan LA at ito po sa ating palatuntunan, layon po natin ipakita at ipamalas ang talento at ganda ng ating bansa. Kasama na rin dito ang mga produktong gawa sa ating Pilipinas, sa ating bansang Pilipinas na talaga namang nagkakaroon na ng mainstream appeal. Sa buong mundo, di lamang dito sa Amerika. Kaya ngayong hapon na to ay minabuti rin natin imbitahin ang dalawa sa pioneers ng abaca industry and the coconut sugar industry sa buong mundo. Celia Tuazon Concepcion, magandang araw sa inyo.
Magandang umaga.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat.
Magandang hapon po sa Pilipinas.
And of course, we have Nicholas Erker.
Good morning.
From Denver, all the way from Denver, Colorado.
All the way. I came out here because it started snowing. Needed some sun.
You needed some sun. Well, you got a lot of sun here in L.A. Now, let's go into what abaca is. It's abaca, like I said in the promo, abaca bao. Kilalang produkto sa Pilipinas. What is it about abaca that all of a sudden parang biglang ding 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 nagkaroon ka ng biglang epiphany na gamitin natin to para sa mas malaking purpose?
Okay. I started like 8 years ago. I own a plantation in the Philippines. It's all planted with Manila hemp. Mm-hmm. Lahat ng tao sa Pilipinas alam ang Manila hemp na ang tawag natin is abaca, which is A-B-A-C-A.
Uh-huh.
Abaca siya.
Then so, walang galang na po, ano ha? Ang abaca para sa ating mga kababayan, kung para dito rin sa Amerika, abaca ang ginagamit natin para sa tali. Yes. Ginagamit natin Manila folder.
Yes.
At saka iba pang mga produkto tulad ng mga pang-sinamay, kung ano-ano pang pangsuot natin.
Yes.
Ngayon, you found a way to make it into a higher quality textile. Can you walk us through that process? Paano nyo nagawa ang abakang matigas? Abakang ginagamit natin pantali, bigla na lang ngayon, isang pangdamit na.
Okay, I started supplying Europe with sinamay. Everybody knows sinamay, ginagamit yan para sa hat.
Okay.
High fashion hats, ginagamit siya sa mga clothing lines na woven, hand-woven siya sa Pilipinas.
I see.
And then I have a scientist who's working with me and he found out the enzyme that comes from Manila hemp, the extracts.
So basically from the plantation, you found a way to harvest the plant and now found science to use for this to make it into a higher quality material. Now, let's go to Nick. What is your involvement with this whole process from the abaca?
Well, Celia and I became friends and we got involved together in the abaca holdings here and I'm vice president of marketing, help with all the different projects that we have going on. And actually got the pleasure of going over to the Philippines here this last year. And, you know, after visiting the Philippines, meeting with a lot of the people there in the Philippines, there's no way I could leave this project.
Now, you invested.
Yes.
Why? What is it about the Philippines that you saw that you were willing to invest money into a product and to a country itself?
Mm-hmm. Well, in the Philippines, there's such a need for development of value-added products. And I mean, there's a lot of rich natural resources in the Philippines, and we just need to find a way to add value to those products and bring them to market. And, you know, working with Celia and her scientists and all these other products would be the coconut sugar, coconut flour, abaca. It's just been an amazing opportunity to help the Philippines and bring some great products to the rest of the world.
Now, you did mention coconut sugar, and I know we have the abaca here. And the abaca, and I think we're going to have some slides for that, actually.
Mm-hmm.
You guys have integrated it within the fashion industry. Hindi lamang po, di ba, sa mga basic products. That is abaca. That is the plant that we're seeing right there, and that's the way that they're stripping off the fiber para magkaroon tayo ng materiales from the leaves, isn't it? From the leaves.
From the bark.
From the bark.
Yeah, the leaves. You can use the leaves to make paper, handmade paper also. Okay, this one, my soap.
So the soap, now if you look at the soap, the cover
the
is actually
paper,
made
that's
of,
from the leaf, yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's it.
And then now that you have kind of tempered that material, and then the bark itself, now you're using it for fashion.
For fabric,
and I think the pictures are going to be up pretty quickly right now to show that it has so many other uses, especially for the fashion industry. Kasi magandang, madaling kulayan, ano ho?
Madali siyang kulayan, and using yung sarili rin nating mga materyales sa Pilipinas, much better to use it. Kasi when I sell it abroad, must they appreciate it more because it's indigenous.
I see, and those are beautiful. Look at that. I mean, it looks almost so soft, unlike what we're used to.
And you can mix it with silk, you can mix it with cotton, you can mix it with polyester. And a lot of designers in our country had been using, it's just like a mixed-use kind of thing for abaca.
Now, Nick, let me ask you this. Where do you see this trend going?
Well, with the abaca fiber fabric, I mean, all those items, they're just tremendous. There's a lot of opportunities for us, be it in mainstream clothing, higher-end clothing. Mm-hmm. You know, with the softening process that we have, the abaca fabric is naturally 10 times stronger than cotton, and with our softening process, it becomes as soft as silk.
Yeah.
So when you have a product that has those kinds of qualities, I mean, the possibilities are limitless.
And what I love about this situation that we have now is that it not only helps us here as the consumers, but it brings back the money to the Philippines, who really needs, and back to agribusiness and the agricultural sector, right?
That's it.
Now, when we come back on Kababayan in LA, we're going to talk about a little bit more of abaca and coconut sugar. So don't go away. We'll be back. Magkakainan po tayo dito.